Game over. Elon Musk and Tesla are terrified about hydrogen cars. Hydrogen cars have been said to threaten Tesla's future, and Elon Musk has not been very friendly concerning the subject. He is terrified. It's a technology that Tesla has not exploited. Now, how can companies like Toyota come from the marshes and give Elon Musk cold feet? Does Tesla have reason enough to be terrified about hydrogen-powered vehicles? Many people will tell you electric vehicles are the future of transportation, and Tesla is at the forefront of this movement. The truth is that battery electric vehicles may not be the best solution for a long time. It's conceivable that the most abundant resource on Earth might be used to power automobiles, and the only waste product would be water. So far, hydrogen-powered vehicles have been less disruptive than Tesla's battery-powered vehicles. The hydrogen fuel cells have been a source of both hope and skepticism since their inception. Hydrogen fuel cell technology is frequently derided by Elon Musk, who's referred to it as a fool cell and mind-bogglingly stupid. However, big manufacturers continue to believe that there's a bright future ahead of them. It's not surprising because they pose dreadful competition for Tesla. And now, how about we start by defining some of the terms? The BEVs, short for battery electric vehicles, as you may have heard, are battery-powered cars, such as Tesla's or Lucid Motors cars, and store electrical energy for use in powering an electric motor. On the other hand, we have the fuel cell electric vehicle, or FCEV, such as Toyota's Mirai, which is powered by a mixture of hydrogen and oxygen. People don't buy Teslas or other electric automobiles for three main reasons. One, due to the time it takes to recharge. Two, they have restricted range. And three, they're more expensive than gasoline-powered vehicles. Now, how do hydrogen-powered vehicles stack up against battery-powered vehicles? When it comes to recharging, hydrogen vehicles are preferable to battery electric vehicles. At a supercharging station, a Tesla can be charged from 30 to 50% in 15 minutes, but it will take more than an hour to fully recharge. For fuel cell vehicles, on the other hand, you don't have to waste a whole 30 minutes on your journey while recharging. Hydrogen stations are now able to refill your car's tank within 5 minutes. That alone is reason enough for concern for Tesla. In the fuel cell vehicles, a generator converting hydrogen to power is used instead of a battery to create power for the motor. When it comes to range, hydrogen-powered vehicles appear to have an advantage over the electric and gas-powered vehicles. With a range of 380 miles, 390 miles, and 400 miles for the current three fuel cell vehicles in production, people have begun showing interest. The normal range of an electric vehicle is less than 300 miles. The average car buyer cannot afford a Tesla, despite the fact that certain models have a range of more than 350 miles. According to automotive executives, fuel cell vehicles will be the game changer for electric mobility. Fuel cell vehicles, on the other hand, have their own set of challenges. The cost of FCEVs needs to be lower. It costs about $20,000 more than an entry-level BEV to buy a fuel cell vehicle. But this price difference is for the three models that are currently on sale. That's because of the auto's low production volume. When only a few hundred or a few thousand units are manufactured annually, it's nearly impossible to compete on price. But things may be about to change. In order to increase their production of FCEVs, there are plans in place. Production capacity for Toyota's Mirai has increased tenfold to lower the vehicle's price. The absence of infrastructure for hydrogen fuel cells is a key problem. Currently, hydrogen fuel is available at more than 40 locations in California for fuel cell owners. According to automotive experts, having a vast network of hydrogen stations is key to the success of FCEVs. Let's say this is one of the goals that the motor industry is gradually achieving. Automakers such as Toyota and others are working together to find hydrogen stations that are most convenient for all of their vehicles. The state of California industrial gas suppliers and other energy providers are also involved in this effort. Thus, they're striving to ensure that any investment that they make is optimally utilized by all of the consumers who will now buy fuel cell vehicles from all of the automakers that provide them. With all the money being pumped on this side, the hydrogen car has a very high chance of taking over. Now, if and when the fuel cell vehicles take off, Tesla will have a difficult time competing. Increasing range while decreasing recharge time and expense will be a challenge. Tesla and other battery electric vehicles are constrained by the law of diminishing returns. To go further, Tesla will need a bigger battery. However, increasing the weight of the vehicle does not extend its range beyond a certain point. With FCEVs, it's all about the numbers. Fuel cell vehicles are more affordable when there are more hydrogen stations, which means more cars and more fuel cell vehicles. With a market share of 60%, Tesla now dominates the electric vehicle market in the United States. Hydrogen fuel vehicles, on the other hand, represent less than 3% of the US electric car market. In terms of the global car market, however, those figures fall. When hydrogen stations become more common, Tesla may lose a big piece of the zero-emissions market to other automakers. Considering how mind-bogglingly stupid this technology is, as Musk says, it still has the ability to challenge Tesla in the same market. As a result, Elon might want to pay attention. Do you think hydrogen vehicles are a reason enough to give Elon a run for his money? Well, that's all for this video. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.